Please welcome Head of Data 42 at Novartis, Birgit Schoeberl.
Good morning. Now we're switching gears. My name is Birgit Schoeberl, Head of Data 42 at Novartis. Novartis is a leading global medicines company, and we focus on science and innovation. I'm really excited to be here today to share with you how we reimagine the way we discover novel, life-saving medicines with the power of data and AIP. So as many probably know, the pharmaceutical industry faces a big challenge. Currently, it takes us about 12 years on average and $3 billion to develop a novel medicine. This is largely driven by a low probability of success. With an odds ratio of 1 in 10,000, for one of our discovery stage molecules synthesized by chemists early on to ever reach regulatory approval. So this is not a problem we can solve with vibe coding alone. So at Novartis, we believe that the improving the probability of success requires three critical elements. So one is the democratized access to context-enriched, integrated data across discovery, preclinical, clinical, and real-world data. World-class scientific talent, and on top of that, intelligent tools, including predictive and generative models that support our scientists in making breakthrough discoveries, going way beyond the classical productivity tools. So for our scientists, and for me, honestly, it's not the goal to go home 30 minutes earlier to walk my dog. It's really, I want to improve this odds ratio and help our patients who are waiting for a new life-saving treatment. With Palantir as our partner, we are building a framework that allows us to use AI agents with scientific depth anchored in our data. So let me share today two examples. So we started working with Palantir relatively early on in 2019 to develop the technology behind Data 42. Some of you might wonder why 42, and I guess I have the coolest job title probably here in the room. We are inspired by the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. So in order to find the answer to life, the universe, and everything, Data 42's mission is to leverage and unlock the value of Novartis' data in a secure and well-governed way. This includes proprietary compound data, preclinical efficacy and safety data, clinical data, including lab data and biomarker data, as well as real-world data, for example, electronic health records. You can see that some of the data, especially biomarker data, can be quite sensitive, but also highly complex. And in order to really fully understand our clinical data, it is essential that we are able to link the structured data to unstructured data in our clinical trial protocols or scientific reports. So by leveraging the Ontology and AIP, Data 42 has been able to combine tens of billions of rows of data from over 700 million patient lives from real-world data, as well as from our 3,000 clinical trials encompassing about a million patients. So this data is now instantly available and all within the secure and well-governed environment. So we have encoded our rich domain knowledge into the ontology by building agents that can extract and connect data across multiple data domains and metadata captured in our documents. In this way, you can easily explore AIP-generated links that connect a single compound, as you can see here in yellow, with our clinical trial data shown in red, biomarker data in green, and preclinical data. So now let's take a first look at the one example of how data explorers can easily query and visualize real-world data from this massive enriched ontology using one of our AIP and augmented tools that is now in production and used across Novartis. It's called ChatRWE. Let's say you're a clinical scientist supporting a project team that is planning a new clinical trial in breast cancer, maybe. So the first question is, can I enroll patients? Do I find the patients given certain inclusion and exclusion criteria? The answer is quite complex. Using real-world data, you typically need to ask a data scientist because you probably don't know how to write SQL queries. And so it takes time, and maybe you just move on. But now, with ChatRWE, that democratizes the access to data with rapid decision-making and allows us to run these cohort feasibility assessments really quickly. So in the ChatRWE tool, the immense complexity of the data, traversal, the synonym retrieval, and output generation is hidden behind a very intuitive user interface. You can see there's a chat and a set of curated visualizations that empower our scientists to understand whether a generated cohort is a good foundation for their research questions. So these visualizations are designed to provide the data explorer with the necessary context on the underlying data, such as, for example, the distribution of age, the comorbidities, clinical labs, lines of prior treatments, etc., for the patient population of interest. Yet for our data scientists, that's really where their work starts, and having access to the multimodal data available on Data42, they can now go do their work in a familiar pro-code environment, such as Jupyter Notebook, to build, for example, new ML or AI models. So now let's take a look at the second example that is in production. We call it Closing the Loop. You will see why. It's an application that we use in all of our early discovery project teams, where we are making hundreds or thousands of compounds to predict the anticipated human dose. So if you think about taking out risk, it's critical to understand and predict what might happen in human. And here we can now predict the anticipated human dose for all of our discovery molecules, learn and compare with our clinical data at scale, and using this automated workflow and AI agents, as I will show you in a little bit. Our goal here was to enable one translational modeler to do something that actually they were not really able to do before. And if done for all projects at scale, basically it would take a much bigger team. So you can see that Closing the Loop is, yes, it's about gaining efficiencies, but it also is, will improve and improves our prediction quality and leads to novel insights. So predicting the right dose from animal experiments is a very complex kinetic modeling process with multiple options. So what we've done with Palantir's AIP agents is to automate the creation of all possible scenarios. This is what wasn't possible before, allowing the modeler to test the impact of different input data and scaling methods. If you do this manually, it just explodes and takes a lot of time. valuable pieces of decision and rationale and scientific context are captured back into the ontology to create a true knowledge base that supports improved predictions downstream. So capitalizing on that, we've constructed AIP agents that combine the insights from historical clinical studies that have been integrated into the Data 42 ontology, as well as organizational and industry best practices to provide recommendations on modeling decisions. So with every prediction and every scientific piece of context that we capture as lab notes, this ontology is enriched and will inform our future predictions. The AI agent not only works through the layers of the workflow, but is also able to transparently justify its recommendations to the modeler via the ontology, allowing for a true human AI partnership. So at the end of this workflow, all modeling decisions, all generated charts, and all data utilized from the ontology are transformed into an electronic lab notebook entry with traceable sources and transparent artifacts to guarantee reproducibility. So in summary, I hope you can see that through this combination of agentic, automated, and ad hoc decision-making support with full decision traceability, we've been able to reduce the time one of our translational modelers usually spends on the human dose prediction per compound by approximately 98% from 1 week down to 2 hours. Today, almost 100% of our small molecule projects use Closing the Loop to help us increase our consistency, reproducibility, and to de-risk projects much earlier, and thus increases our probability of success. So, to summarize, if you combine comprehensive data, brilliant scientists, and truly intelligent tools, you can fundamentally change the process of drug discovery. So imagine being able to supercharge also your data scientist with best-in-class access to data, efficient tools, and increasingly autonomous and context-rich agents. Thank you.